Evening folks, this is Bestin Slot and welcome back to a little bit more custom building in Planet... Oh, he's got a balloon. Custom building in Planet Zoo. We're going to continue with our African adventure today. There is trash all over my zoo. I really need to hire another janitor. I'm just making sure I've got the money to afford it. Yeah, we're fine, whatever. I know he's on it. Look at him. Good lad. Anyways, I have once again been a little busy since the last video. I've realised that if I want to finish this entire zoo before the beta ends, I'm going to have to do quite a lot of work between videos. I might start time-lapsing it in the future, but even then, it's like 8 hours of work, right? So it's going to be a massive time-lapse. Anyways, let's move forward and we'll take a look at what's changed. This hasn't changed. This hasn't changed. You see, we've not been there yet. Though you may see some weird pathing on the ground, which I'll explain shortly. The major thing that's changed is this building right here. This big-ass building right here. I'm not in love with it, to be honest. I kind of started building it and I built the shell and I put the animals in and then I got a little bit annoyed with it and I kind of wanted to undo it, but I'd put so much work in already that I kind of committed to finishing it. I do, however, love this. This is my hippo. His name is Roger. This is Roger. And Roger sits on a rock and Albert tortoise, sable antelope, capo flown ostrich, mandrills all on that way to the left. And some of these will point to the right as well. We'll mix it up. But there's Roger. I just think he looks great. I think that's proper zoo kind of stuff right there. You know, look at that view. I'm just gonna Ansel. Look at that. That's beautiful. In my opinion. Anyways, moving on. So we worked on the sable antelope in the last video, and then I went and built another exhibit over here, which is the buffalo slash ostrich exhibit. You can see them there. Again, the sound's gone mental. I think it's when I go into Ansel, the sound kind of dies. I wonder if I pause. Yeah, that fixes it. So this is my ostrich slash buffalo exhibit. We've got some baby ostriches roaming around, not dying this time, which is nice. Got a little bit of a shelter over there. We've got a large sort of motor on the outside. Buffaloes are both female, so they can't breed, but the ostriches are both silver. We've got males. Oh no, we've got a golden ostrich there, and where's our female ostrich? Where's she at? She's gold as well, so we should be having some like top level babies, basically. Yeah, little golden babies. So hopefully we can sell these and get a little ostrich farm going, basically. There they are. Lagtastic. Adorable. So, got 1, 2, 3, 4. Jeez, we've got 5 baby ostriches. And I'm going to show you the building in a second. But if we go up here, you can see it's obviously a elevated path. I put this cladding around it, which looks really good to me. This sort of cladding that we've seen. We've been using this for the whole park, really. This is my Africa stuff. It is worth keeping in mind that the Africa theme isn't even in the game right now. It would have been perfect for all of this, but unfortunately I don't have access to it, so I've just kind of had to, you know, make do with our New World stuff, basically. But we've got this little elevated area here. And then if you carry on walking, you can walk down over there if you want to be a little lazier, but you can walk down here if you want. Do-do-do-do-do. Down we go. Got a little same staff areas earlier in the game. Honestly, I was just being a little bit lazy, but I tried to theme the outside of it to look a bit better. I've got this trellis kind of stuff on the outside, which I really like. It breaks up the monotony a little bit. I think it looks pretty cool. We're going to start using that a little bit more. I think this feels suitably African. Oh, yes, somebody pointed out. I had actually realized in time, but somebody pointed out none of my exhibits had rocks in them. I don't think I've put any in here. Oh, yeah, I have there. I went a little calmer on this one, but I went a little mental on this one. Rocks are amazing. I love rocks. Rocks are the best. The reason I hadn't put them in is because they're not actually organized into any group at all. If you go into nature and you've got any filter on, the rocks won't show up. You just have to search rock with a 1K, not 2, unless you like really want to rock out. And you see all the rocks there. Rocks are amazing, and they don't... I don't know if they take up room, but the point is they look cool. And that's really all that matters. I know I go a little heavy on the foliage as well, but it's just who I am. Anyways, so that's a little staff area. And then we move down here. Brick wall is temporary, and that is about it. So, oh yeah, the building. We should talk about the building. So this... Alright, Roger. This is my tortoise house. Like I said, I'm not in love with it. I've been struggling for a long time. It used to look a lot more boring than this. I actually did it up a little bit earlier on. I might get rid of the vines. I'm not convinced that the vines are a good idea. But we'll see. I was going for... I had this... Oh, who's in lockdown? Okay. How are you, Pop Love? I just really wanted to do an indoor-outdoor exhibit for my tortoises, one where you can see them on the inside, you can see them outside. I just really, really liked that idea for some reason, and decided to go for it. So, I kind of had like some inspiration from all these other zoos I've seen, so we go inside, do-do-do-do-do, as you can see, and you can... I wanted it to be... Okay, it's a tortoise house, but it's also kind of like an ecological education thing as well, so we've got a lot of these eco-boards up. You can change colour off, by the way, it looks really cool. Little seating area here with a bench. It's just a little indoor bit, so you can see the tortoise run all the way around indoors and outdoors. And indoors is all sandy, and outdoors is all sort of foresty and grasslandy. I think it looks quite cool. I wish I'd made the building a lot bigger so I could have done this properly, but what I would have liked to do is have the path come down on the other side as well, but I'm kind of committed to this now. And we go up here. Now, you'll see there's some donation boxes and stuff here. The idea is when we build this exhibit here, you'll be able to look out from the top off the tortoise house and look down into the exhibit. I think people are not going to like the green. I am going back and forth on the green. I actually think I like it. I think it's necessary to mix it up a little bit. I think once we get some forest and trees and stuff in front of this part, the whole thing is going to come together a little bit more. I'm still not convinced about the vines. I think I'm going to kill the vines. I'm like 90% sure about that. But anyways, yeah, quite like it in sorts. And yeah, you'll be able to stand out here and look out into what will eventually be a warthog slash springbok exhibit. If we zoom out a little bit, you'll see I've, I kind of started to, basically I went onto Word and I made a Word file, a document, and I wrote down every single exhibit I want and what section I want them to be in. Now, African Adventure is definitely the biggest one, but I've got like ideas for all the others as well. We're gonna do like a bear section and a big cat section and an Asian section and a reptile house and blah, 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 blah. Oh no, oh, right, good. So. I currently have a breeding pair of hippos. As you can see, we've got a female hippo, we've got a male hippo. The problem is they kind of kill each other instantly. Like the male hippos will not like happily live together. Now you're the alpha, I'm actually gonna keep you around. So we're gonna call the vet, and then what we're gonna do is sell Ogbonna, unfortunately. Basically, I'm just keeping a breeding pair of hippos, let them have a kid, sell the kid. The incest and the diseases and stuff is not currently actually in the game. So if you want to keep breeding, like, if you want to breed your babies together, you can totally do that. I mean, maybe wait till they're not babies anymore. That would be a better idea. But you can breed brothers and sisters. You know, just let everyone have sex, basically. It's like the 60s. Right, so we're going to heal those and then sell one of them off. And hopefully that's going to get some more conservation credits. Because I still need some very expensive animals, like elephants and stuff like that. Anyway, it says you updated tour. It's good, right? Like I said, I'm not convinced on the house. I think if I get rid of the vines and then maybe put some trees around the back, I think that'll help a lot. But we're getting them. Anyways, so yes, what we're going to work on today is this. Ma for mandrill. Ladies and gentlemen, we're working on the mandrill exhibit today. And I have already come up with a little bit of a plan. I've already put, like I said, we're going to get rid of the barrier. But this is the edge here, so I've already put the trees in. It's basically all set up so we can get some serious work done in this video focused entirely on the mandrills. Okay, 10 minutes in, now we can get to work. First things first, I want a moat. I know you're injured, but you're fine, right? Aren't you? The vet's on the way. You'll be fine. The vet is on the way. Ah, that, right, that's the first one done. So we'll wait till they're cured and then we'll get rid of one of them. Okay, work, right. So the idea is to build a moat, first of all. I want the moat to be, like, there's always going to be a fence here because I'm like covering all my path with this fence. So I just want like quite a, not too deep, but not too shallow. As helpful as that is, I'm sure. Not too deep, not too shallow, like that, I think. All the way around where this exhibit is gonna be. And I want this to not have that effect. I hate that. That's when you get too close to a fence, it just goes mental. So we're just gonna try and stay, leave a little bit more of a gap at the edge, basically. So it doesn't have that crazy effect. Just like so. I'm just gonna go all the way around and make a little moat. Keeping it very classic zoo. Do, 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 do. And then I'm thinking chain link fence beyond the moat. I think it's quite cool sometimes to mix up where you put your fences, essentially. Sometimes have them right by the path, sometimes have them a little bit further on, sometimes have another fence in front of them, stuff like that. Honestly, I think I get a lot of comments, like, people really like my zoo, and it's been really nice to see, by the way. Thank you so much for all the comments, it's been really complimentary overall. Oh, I want to show you something as well. I know that our little, not even an antelope technically, that this little guy over here is American. I know that, but he's also the only one in the game. We're going to have more statues and stuff when the game actually comes out, but until then, I'm just kind of using stuff. I considered using, like, something else as a turtle. I can't remember what it was going to be, but it wasn't a turtle. Well, I looked for a turtle. I would have used the turtle for a tortoise if need be, you know, just because not everything is in the game quite yet, so it's more about trying to make everything look as good as possible with what we've got. Like I said, we don't even have the African stuff in the game yet, so doing an African zone first is probably a bad idea. Bam. There we go. That's Mandrill Island. So, barriers. Now, can we make the chain link unclimbable? Is that a thing? Let's find out. It doesn't curve, does it? No. I have a horrible suspicion they're easily just going to climb over that. Right? Why would they not? It's a chain link fence. Can I make it so they can't? Is it in this bit? I think it's in this bit. Okay, so that doesn't seem to have the option. If we then make... I just want to test this out, basically. There is a thing where you can make it so animals can't climb on top of it. I'm not seeing it right now. I'm just going to make the bloody thing, and we'll go from there. Let's just make the bloody thing. And we're going to stick with the same. Where's my chain link? I did start working on the barrier research. I got this one, Gabion. I hate it. It's awful. I don't know why it's research, but whatever. We would like the moat to be maybe a little bit deeper, but that's okay. And this is the closest we've got to like the mesh. Usually you'd have like a big rope mesh, right? And surround the monkey exhibits with that, or the ape exhibits with that. Anything that's going to climb, you want to surround it with a big mesh. But we don't have that option. You gotta make do, folks. You gotta make do. There we go. I think that's a decent sized exhibit. We are going to have to build a little bridge for our... Yeah, that's going to be cool. We're going to build a little bridge over here. Oh, such a pain in the ass. I keep forgetting that it is a pain. Boop. Okay. Maybe I can just increase the height so it looks more like a netting, I guess. Something like that. It looks pretty cool, actually. I quite like that. Let's get our mantle sent over. Let's just do it. Obviously, there's lots to do still, but that's okay. See the elephants? 700, 590. We're not that far. I can actually afford an elephant, but I want two. So we need 991. But we're not that far away from getting breeding elephants. And once we get breeding elephants, we're going to make a lot of money. I know people have issues with the wild dogs. Honestly, because you can filter, it doesn't really matter. It is kind of annoying, but... Anyways, let's get our mandrills in. They're not great mandrills. Really, you know, they're both default. Hopefully when we get some more points we can update the gold as well, but let's get those in there. Lovely stuff. Speed up time. Chum chum. There's a staff center really close by as well. I do want to start pushing over to the right. So the idea is the safari is like the last bit on the left hand side of the zoo. Because I want the Africa section to kind of come back over here and tie back in with the main path. Probably around here and then maybe a little bit further. Yeah, probably just around here. All we have to put in other than this. So this is going to be Warthog and Springbok, I believe. This is a few other things, like elephants, giraffes, zebras, you know, typical safari stuff. There's going to be a lemur exhibit, and there's going to be an African wild dog exhibit in this area here. And then that's going to go back onto the main bit, and then we'll carry on and carry on and carry on and carry on. There's loads of room over here to the left, but we don't need it, to be honest. So it's going to go with this. I want to get the mandrills in, just so we can... see what they need. There we go. Message center, exciting. So like I said, I kind of like the idea of this going up a little bit, more like an island, but in the center. And hopefully that incentivizes them not to climb out as well. We might have to swap this with something else, but we'll see. So we want to do sculpting, want to do pull, and we want to do big. Okay, we don't want to do that, that's silly. It's actually too much already. I didn't want it to be a mountain per se. I just wanted it to be a little bit higher. Let's bring that right down. I'll tell you what, we're just smooth. Smooth is the best. Smooth is the answer to all of life's problems, folks. Smooth this out around there. Spend all my money. I want it a little bit higher than this. I'm going to bring it up and then smooth it again. And hopefully that's going to give us something a bit better looking. Smooth it out! The reason I have no money, by the way, is because I never play the game. The game, that's okay. I didn't really want it to be a big thing, so that's fine. I kind of want some water in here as well. I didn't think about that. That's the problem with this design. I should have had some of the water go in. We'll just do a little thing. That's fine. It's fine. Totally part of the plan. Go push. Plant foundation. That's way too deep. It's important to smooth as well, especially with your water sections, just because your animals will struggle to drink from any like super steep area, basically. There we go. Good stuff. Little drinking pond bit. Looks a bit silly with the canal already there, but whatever. How happy are we? Just in general. Terrain. Yeah, we need some elevation, but in terms of actual land area, we've got plenty of stuff. So, I want to build some custom stuff, but for now I also want to just kind of stick it in. I was lucky enough, I've upgraded my habitat. How much does this cost me? Oh, it's nothing. Let's have a little look. We've got tons of really cool climbing frames. These are all part of one of the research blueprints. Look at that one. That's very cool. I'm going to stick that right smack bang in the middle. And then... I reckon they need a shelter? I don't really want to give them a shelter. They can sit under the climbing frame. It's fine. I want to give them like an option to jump across, right? So they should, I think, be able to go... Let's just put that at a slightly better angle. That should be like an alternate way to get up there. Now we need to give them a way to get up onto here, though. Onto this little guy here. And this is also like a little way to get into the water. I guess. It goes round and then up onto the big one. And we'll put something special at the top. God knows what. Anything else we want to do? General climbing logs. Have another little bit over here. Let's kind of string those together to make something a little weird. I like that. That look good. I mean, I didn't do anything, but it looks good. That's what matters. Mandrill. What have we got? Do we have any toys? Yes, we've got a sprinkler. I'm going to stick that over there. Got a grab ball, which will help as well. We can do some stuff. Maybe. We've got forage box enrichment as well. Nice. Oh, no. I want to put this somewhere... The problem is it's huge. I want like a smaller one. I'm going to put some bedding though. On what I want to do is like a big platform. What's the biggest platform we can do? Can I put that on top? Yeah, come on. Okay, are you flat? Can I get up there? Maybe if I put this kind of like on one side. This will make sense eventually. Right, let's just grab that. Let's fix that because that's a disaster. Okay, 10 trillion years later, I think I'm relatively done. I like the idea, actually, if I just grab one of these as well. Oh, no, that's separate. I was thinking, I like that being in like a loop to attach back into there. This feels like it's verging on excessive at this point, though. I mean, that's probably enough. The tower is still a little more haphazard than I would like, but I really hope they can make their way up there. Right, so we need to make the exhibit more suitable, and they need food and stuff like that. They need lots of basics. I am a little bit on the poor side, but we can't really unpause right now, so we've got to roll with this. So let's do just that. We're rolling. We're going to go for a feed bowl. Where are people going to stand? Just anywhere around the side, right? It'd be nice to get like a... maybe an elevated path. You have to be a little bit careful, because it's a mandrel at the end of the day, and I've already used a lot of elevated paths, but I'm thinking we can make this one here elevated. I think it's far enough away that it wouldn't be an issue. They've got water already, but I do like to put a food cage. Oh, cool, look at that. I'll put that on somewhere. I'll put that on top. Anyone who can get up there deserves it. I'm going to put that there. That is really cool. Oh, I like that. Yeah, I didn't think about that. What else we got? Wait, what's a food cage for? Is it for the mandrels? No, what am I on about? That's for... not for mandrels. I don't know why I'm trying to get that on the mandrels. Isn't that for, like, elephants and stuff? It could work, though. If you loaded that with mandrel food, they'd climb up and eat from it. In theory. Yeah, I'm going to put in a water bowl. Why am I not seeing food? Am I going crazy? Is it only the forage box? There's no other food. What? Oh, feeding platforms. That makes more sense. I'm gonna put one up there. It's a cheeky one. How do our zookeepers do? I've never played around with this. I don't know how our zookeepers do it. I'm gonna put one up here. This is a more chill one. Oh, very cool. Right. So, that should be some happy mandrels. I do want to put the forage box in, but it's so huge that I really don't want to. So, that doesn't really make any sense. Right then. So, let's make them a little bit happier with plants and terrain and such. We need... let's slow that down as well. We need... click the right button, first of all. We need more short grass and a lot less long grass. I've got a lot of long grass always, because I think it looks really good for this kind of savanna feel that I'm going for. But the mandrels are less happy about it. And admittedly, this does probably suit the mandrels a bit more. We also need some dirty dirt. I'm going to try to put this... I'm going to go for heavy. I'm going to try to get this around the outsides. Around the outside. Yeah, I went a little farther. It's okay. There we go. Looks pretty cool. Need more long grass now. Of course we do. There we go. Right. Are we happy? Are we going to stop complaining about that terrain? Yes. That says it's bad, but that's just because we've got the game paused. That'll fix. Environment. Yes. Finally, an animal that needs trees. Finally. I've been waiting so long. All the animals hate trees. Like, if we go over here to my sables, you'll see if we click on them and go here. They're actually very unhappy with their plant coverage. Everything else is so good that it doesn't really matter overall. I'm kind of just ignoring them, to be honest. But, yeah, it's exciting. You actually could do some enrichment, couldn't you? Food enrichment. I believe I've researched these guys quite a lot. We should be able to stick something in here. Let's have a little look. Species. Sabel. Food enrichment. Yeah, cool. There we go. Should make them a bit happier, see? Yeah, sweet. Gotta keep an eye on that kind of thing. Did a lot of research. What's going on here? Not okay. We are low on cash. This time I'll accept their decision. It looks cool though. Very cool. How does he get up? How do the keepers do this? I'm very curious to find out. right. Yes, trees. Let's bring up our mandrel, get onto the terrain page, and then nature, and we're looking for... oh no, I clicked the wrong button. I wonder why that wasn't working. We're looking for tropical. I think this is actually the first time we've done a non-grassland exhibit as well. For the Africa section. So, Africa, tropical, exciting stuff. Yes, gonna enjoy this. Big tree. No, right, we have to be careful with big trees. We have to be very careful with the big trees. They will climb the big trees. So we're gonna put a couple of these dotted around. This is my favorite part, it always is. Bring you down. I really like doing this. It doesn't always make sense for every plant, but it's just a good way of mixing things up a little bit. It's just hold shift and bring the plant down into the ground, and it really does change how things look. I've been using the reeds a lot. You can see them here, but I don't I don't like it when they look like big, massive piles of reeds. But if you bring them into the earth a little bit, they just look like interesting plants sticking out, and they look a lot better, in my opinion. I've been playing a lot of this game. Oh, the tamarinds. These are what I was using ages ago, back at the start of the park. Is that going to be okay? I just want one big tree. I think that should be okay. That'll be fine. Yes. I love this kind of stuff. This is where your park comes alive for me. The plant life is really the best bit. You want to tell a story. I don't know what my story is here, but... Bum, bum, bum. Live the dream. Why not? It's going to be hard to see in there, but that's okay, I think. Coconut palms. Just dot a couple of these around so it blends in a little bit better. Oh, neglecting over here. That can't be good. Let's get a fern. This is one I already used. Yeah, let's get a little babby one. I love this. They're fine, like, having loads more than this. This isn't nearly too much for the mandrills. I really like that. I've been dealing with animals that hate plant life. I love putting plants down, and I've been dealing with animals that hate it for the entire bloody game so far. So it's really nice to be able to do this kind of thing. Not that, though. That's a disaster. I'm just keeping an eye on my money. Hey, there he goes. He's on the move. Oh, he's fallen off. What a nerd. Oi. You have to click move before they escape. Right, this obviously is not sustainable. I have no money, however, so what we need to do is get a little bit of cash and then change the mandrill exhibit. I knew this was going to happen, but part of me was optimistic for some stupid reason. I accept full responsibility, obviously. It was very daft, but it is what it is. Right, I need to find a barrier type that can actually not go crazy. Maturity! What have we got? We've got four babies. My babies. Oh, that's it, really. Oh, Nassau's still in the trade. My hippo has not sold quite yet. My two gold ostriches. No one's had any babies? No one's had any babies. Cool. Right. No. Right, see, you can do it on this climb-proof top. That's what we're looking for. I don't want to do that on these, though. I should be able to build. Well, right, let's just try some different barriers out. How am I meant to do that? How are you meant to ever see the mandrills? Because I can do this, and then we can do a climb-proof top, but you can't see through. We're going to have to do windows. That's stupid. I don't want to cover the whole thing in wood. I don't know what else to do, though. I actually don't know what else to do. I don't know what my alternative is, so... I can bring it right down and make it a climb-proof top. It doesn't have to be this tall. But the chain link fence makes a lot of sense logically. Like, it makes more sense logically. Right? I'm a little bit annoyed about this. I don't know how other people are doing their mandrill exhibits. Maybe I just need to unlock more barrier types? I don't know what to build it out of. It's corrugated out of... None of them have... it's only the wood that can... do it anyway. Alright, we're gonna do this for now. It's very obsessing. I'm gonna bring it down. To there. That's left. Now is that... I'm gonna set both. Just set both, I think. Right, so they can't get out. At least they can't get out. Nobody can see them, but they can't get out. What's going on here? Okay, my game's clearly gone a little bit mental. The game is, like, broken. Okay. I'm making money, though. Need to do something about this. This is obviously not... I mean... It doesn't look as bad as I thought it did, I've got to be honest. I'm not that disillusioned with this, actually. If they can't get out, they might just be able to leap out. I'm hoping this is tall enough to stop them, because everything's very central. It actually looks okay. The game is broken, I'm going to have to restart the game. I like Mandrill Island, I really like this water. I want a little bit more water in this world to kind of get... I'm kind of going now, for some reason, like a pirate kind of theme going on here. We'll get some of these plants and surround the area with them as well. We've been using the grassland ones, but I kind of want to blend them in with the exhibit a little bit. I'm going to restart the game. I'm going to fix this. Everything's going to be fine. Everything's fine. Okay. The game seems to be working. Yes. Game seems to be working. Yes, can you climb out? That is the first test. Will they escape? I'm going to bring up the fence a little bit for safety's sake. Just a little bit. It feels a little bit short for me. Just a teeny tiny bit, though. About there. What are you doing? Now, you'll see if you look in the bottom left, I have money. Like I said, we do earn decent money at this park. It just takes a little time sometimes. And I have 1,300 conservation points. My hippo has apparently sold in the meantime when I was offline. I just updated the game. There's a little bit of a patch and stuff like that. So I spent about 20 minutes doing that. Let's have a little look at our animal list. Maturity. Yeah, I don't want to breed my Galapagos. So we've got my 4 baby ostriches still. 2 adult sables, 2 adult ostriches, 2 adult mandrills, 2 adult buffalo, 2 adult hippos, 2 adult... I've got 2 of everything. I'm basically nowhere. And then the 4 ostriches will get sold. So, okay. We're looking good. Now, next step is to put windows on these. I guess that's not a terrible alternative. I mean, it's not what I wanted to do, but it's not the end of the world. What I would like is the ability to hold control and click multiple ones. Because I don't want to do every one, because that's silly. That's not design, folks. That's not design. We do every... Why are you getting boxed up every 5 seconds? What's wrong with you? You know what? You can bloody stay there for a minute, alright? I'm busy. Doing my thing. And what we're doing right now is praying that it happens to be the perfect number, so that when I got... Oh, sweet, my switch is pregnant again. Maybe when... This is a general tip, folks. So one of the best ways to make money and stuff in this game is pregnancies, right? I would recommend not breeding certain creatures. Lizards and stuff are kind of a pain in the ass. The problem is you can't sell babies. I'm going to talk about this in an upcoming video. There needs to be a way to get rid of babies. If they don't massively nerf the breeding rate, damn it. I'm just one off. Okay, what we're going to do, we're just going to pause it. I can't live in that world. We're going to delete that and just extend that to there. There you go. Every other block. Perfect. Yeah, it's pretty cool. There's too many babies, basically, for like some creatures like Gharials will have like 20 babies. So what I would do is probably make like a nursery and breed them all there and then sell them off eventually. Something like that, I think, is my plan for the future. Right now, there's no way to get rid of babies. I think there has to be a way to get rid of babies, because babies can just ruin your zoo. They really can. So what I would suggest, Frontier, if you happen to be watching this, is a way to get rid of kids. Maybe not even sell them, maybe even pay a fee. You know, it's your fault for recklessly breeding these animals, but you need to be able to get rid of babies, because people keep losing their zoos to disastrous babies. If they massively nerf birth rates and stuff like that, that stops being an issue, I guess. You're not having a good time, are you? Why are you going ment- What? Okay, folks, I am going to say that is finished, or at least somewhat finished. I realise that this isn't a mandrill, by the way, but again, like with the, you can tell you what, it says animals, let me just change that. Mandrill. Why can't I type? Never mind, I didn't want to do it anyway. So, nothing I care about here. That's fine. It will have power soon. That's okay. Everything is fine. So, yeah, I'm going to call it. I'm pretty... My game's gone crazy again. Why does this keep happening? Yeah, I'm pretty happy with it. I think it looks pretty great. I'm a little disappointed we couldn't go for the chain link, but I've got to say, I think the wooden fencing has kind of convinced me otherwise, you know, that maybe this was the right idea in the first place. With the windows in it and stuff like that, that big mountain in the middle. What are you up to? Oh, Just pooping. I'm just pooping, you know how I be. Yeah, so this is one of the problems with the keepers. They do this thing where they... Yeah, you tell them you need food, right? So I've just clicked on the feeding platform and said, I need food in this exhibit. So the keeper came and walked into the exhibit, saw that we need food, and then left. Because what you're doing is you're not calling the keeper to the food itself. I think what you're always doing is actually calling the keeper to the exhibit. So this is why it wasn't working with the tortoises before, because the keeper walks in, sees that there's a massive pile of food, and thinks, well, we're fine, right? We don't need to do anything. He's trying to climb the tree. It's not going well for the mandrill. He's trying to climb the tree. He's giving it a good old college try. Cool though, right? Very cool. Very cool. Look at that. Beautiful. Snap. You can do it, buddy. You can do it. I believe in you. Where's my camera? You've given up. That's fine. Giving up is the noble way to do it. Where's the other one? Where's the female? I'd like to get some more in there, so even if they have... Oh, there she is. Even if they have kids, which I don't think she's pregnant yet. No. Even if they have kids, I think we'll let some of them grow up and just have... You know, it'd be cool to have like 4 or 5, 6 mandrills maybe roaming around the area. I think that would look a lot better than what we've got here. There you go. Yeah, really happy with how this has turned out. This is definitely the best thing I've done on video, I think, in my opinion. But I did spend 2 hours, so that would probably be why. Thank you for joining me. Cheers, myself, as always. Bye-bye. Hey, folks. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you want to help support me a little bit more, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. There's a link in the description down below. Every little really does help in times like these, but it's not at all expected, and by just watching the video, you've already helped me out massively, and it makes you a pretty cool person, so well done you. Thanks for joining me either way. I'll see you next time.